Here I have a BiLock Generation 1 rim cylinder. There's the key for it. Two rows of six pins, sidebar on each side. Key does work. Going to use a Peterson pry bar on the left side and just go through and feel for a binding pin and try to set it. Back and forth between the two sides, trying to find something binding. Some deep cuts in this, and pick wants to get stuck in it, but stuck under one of these pins here. This lock I got Saturday. Picked it once today. There it is, finally. 5 minutes, 46 seconds. About damn time. Picked. Ooh, okay. On the back here, I have a paper clip. There's a roll pin that holds the cylinder in, but a roll pin is a pain. So, again, it's picked. There's locked back up. Actually, upside down, locked back up, but. Got her locked up in the 180 position, of course. Dang it. That's what that pick's for. Now let's get the tailpiece off and see if we can just slide it out the front. Show you that it does have all the pins in it. It's gonna be a long video. Not having a very good time here. Ah, there we go. There's the tailpiece. Okay, yeah, it didn't have any. I can just slide her out the front. There we go. Okay, there it is. There's the sidebar. There's the other sidebar. I'm gonna turn it over. And there you can see it does have all 12 pins in it. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 9. 10, 11, and 12. There's the front of the core. It's got the BiLock symbol on it. I'm not gonna pop the cap right now. I'll take it apart a little bit later and have a breakdown of it on keypicking.com to show you what the pins look like in this one. But there it is, BiLock Generation 1, single pin picked. Thanks for watching.